Hey everybody, there's nobody on just yet, but people are coming. Is waiting a little bit until people come on. Hey everybody, good afternoon. Hey. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. This is my fourth virtual concert. I am literally so excited. You guys truly, I know, are being blessed by this. And so I'm kind of back by popular demand. And so I appreciate you guys for coming back and tuning in. How are you? Are you staying safe? I know you probably are. Are you wearing your masks? That's a very important thing. We got to keep everybody safe and healthy. And you know, are you making your voice heard? Are you voting? Are you taking part in any rallies or any giving to the African American community? What's going on, y'all? How's it going? Hope everybody's doing well. Like I said, this is my fourth. Hi, everybody. This is my fourth Facebook Live, and I'm so excited to be here. I'm here just to bring you guys joy. This is essentially just a time for you to escape from the craziness of the world, and for you to just, you know, kind of have a musical escape. And that's what I'm here for. So without further ado, I'm going to take you guys back to 1992 on a magic carpet ride in one of my favorite films of all time. This song was written by the amazing, amazing, amazingly talented composer Alan Menken. Lyrics by Howard Ashman from the movie Aladdin. This is A Whole New World. So enjoy. Songs in the entire world, a beautiful, beautiful composition written by the amazing Howard Ashman and Alan Menken from Disney's Aladdin. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. If you're just tuning in, welcome to my studio. We're live here from Nashville, Tennessee. Socially distanced, of course. How's everybody's week going? Mine's been super, super busy. I'm so fortunate to have been able to, at a safe distance, record an EP for one of my artist that came here from Florida. Her name is Danae, and many of you guys have heard her, seen her on my page, and She's written an amazing body of work that we produced here at my company, and it's really been an amazing week. So the EP is coming out on the 21st of August. So if you want to check it out, check it out. But she's an amazing talent, and so that's kind of been my week, just composing and producing music for her, and making sure everything is good, and preparing to see you guys here in the Lion's Den, essentially. So we're gonna just keep this concert moving. Again, I'm just here to bring you joy. So sit back, relax. Get your wine, get your dog, put your feet up, do whatever you want to do. This is your time to just kind of chill and let me serenade you. So this next song I'm going to play is one that I actually haven't played in a long time. I'm taking it like way, 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 way back. Like for real, like so far back, like 10 years ago, almost 10 years ago to my very first album. This was 2011. Oh, the night, I can remember like it was yesterday. Cedar release party downtown at the Standard in Nashville, and on this particular CD, I composed and produced a song along with my producer, Mike Taylor at the time, called Life in the Tropics. And since we're all kind of grounded and we can't go anywhere, I was expecting to go to Cancun this summer, but COVID. And so I'll try to bring the tropics to you through this next song. So this is Life in the Tropics from my first album, Artistic Touch, 2011. And I got a beat for you too, so enjoy it. Thank you. haven't played that one in like forever. That was so long ago, and it was actually one of my favorites that I, when I wrote it, I'm just kind of like, okay, I'm thinking of a place that's like super beachy and stuff. And so if you go back and listen to the track, this was like 14, 15 year old BRYARD. And I had this like crazy like slap bass, like providing the rhythm, and then I had done the beat on top of it, and it was all kinds of amazing. But I hadn't played it in a long time, and so what a joy to play it for you guys tonight. And hopefully I got you to kind of reminisce on what the tropics are like, since we're all kind of grounded because of COVID. So again, if you're just joining me, hello, welcome. What is this? What a great way to spend my evening, sitting in a lawn chair. Oh my God, Mary, I love you. Welcome to my fourth concert in quarantine and studio hang series. I'm so happy that you guys are here. Allow me to bring you some joy for the evening. But also, I wanted to thank you guys. I mean, I want to leave this out. I want to thank you because many of you all have seen the Stand By Me collaboration that I did with the artists on my record label and musical friends of mine. And I just really appreciate it because you guys have been streaming it and watching it and sending it to other people. And I know it's brought a lot of people some joy, and so that's really why I do what I do, as you guys know. And so I'm just blessed to be here and blessed to be able to entertain you during this hour time that we have together. So thank you so much. If you want to check it out, it's on YouTube, but it's a great way to just kind of, you know, reflect and think. If we all stand as one, we'll all be all right, y'all. I'll be all right. So okay, what do we have next? I believe that we have a very, 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 very special guest coming up for a little bit of a throwback song. So please put your virtual hands together in your kitchen, your bathroom, your bedroom, or your patio for my baby brother, JJ. Jaran, where is he?
I'm right here.
There he is, y'all. There he is. There he is. What's up, man?
I'm chilling.
All right, well, he's chilling like a villain. We're gonna take it back a little bit to you to an old, it's not that old, is it? It's not that old, is it? Because you saw the movie. It's not that old, like 60s, 70s.
Maybe later.
We're gonna do a little Elton for you, if you don't mind. I got my sunglasses, I'm gonna show you guys. I don't know if you can see them, but they're like bedazzled sunglasses. I call them my Elton John glasses. And Jared's gonna put his on. We got you just for this one. This is Benny and the Jets by Elton John. The way we know how to do it.
Thank you.
That was Elton John's Benny and the Jets featuring my baby bro Jaran Huggins on piano here. Yes. And we're just here to entertain you tonight. So again, right. Sit back, relax, and just enjoy. We'll catch up with you later on in the show. So he'll be out, but he's gone, but he'll be right back. And so for those of you who are just joining me, hey, what's up? Welcome to my fourth concert in quarantine studio and studio hang live. I'm so excited that you guys are here. Thank you so much for joining, and thank you so much for all the support. I hope you all are staying safe and healthy and doing everything that you can to make sure that everybody else is staying healthy as well. And so I appreciate you guys for tuning in. I just want to bring you some joy. That's why I do what I do. That's why I want to bless you with a night of amazing music. And so I do want to give a shout out though, because we've got somebody, I'm not sure if they're on because it's a lot of people, but Joan and Terry Eastland are my dear friends, and they're always really supportive for me of me, and they used to live down the street from me. Actually, they like watched me grow up, I think they're on tonight. Hopefully they are. But if not, we wanted to wish them a very happy 55th wedding anniversary, you guys. That's what love looks like. They've stayed together for all these years, and that's just totally amazing. And so, shout out to Miss Joan, Mr. Terry, the Eastlands. Love you guys. Thank you so much for your support, and I hope you enjoyed this night. And you're celebrating it here with me, so I appreciate that. So happy anniversary, guys. And so next song that I have on the agenda to play for you, we're going to kind of take it down a little bit from the hype. And this is actually a song that one of my really, really, really good friends recommended that I learn and try to play for a Facebook Live concert. So I thought I'd incorporate it into this show. And it has a really good message. It's, you know, it's basically kind of, I think, taking off the Maya Angelou quote that was basically saying that, you know, despite whatever clouds and rain may be around, you always have a rainbow within them. And I think that's really indicative of where we are now. You know, it may seem cloudy, it may seem stormy, but hey, God put a rainbow in the clouds. And so Casey Musgraves actually says it a lot better than I just did, but she actually sings it. And I wrote a song about it. So this is Rainbow. I see you, Mary. This is Rainbow, my arrangement of Rainbow by Casey Musgraves. Shout out to Mary Grace Allen for this recommendation. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you. Casey Musgrave's hit from her album Golden Hour, Rainbow. Recommended by my dear, dear, dear friend, Mary Grace Allen. I hope you enjoyed it, Mary. I love you, I love you, I love you, girl. I love you. If you guys are just joining, I think I saw Miss Jackie, Miss Barbara. Hi, guys. Thank you guys so much for joining. This is my fourth concert in quarantine and studio hang. I hope you all are staying safe and healthy. And I'm just giving you a night of music. God's blessed me with the gift, and I want to share the gift with other people to bring some joy in these crazy, crazy times we're living in. And so just sit back, relax, don't think about CNN, don't think about Fox, don't think about MSNBC, don't think about anything else. It's all about your escape and music. Let's keep your mind clear and relaxed for this hour that I have you before I release you back to the world. Until next time. And so we're just gonna keep on trucking. I think we're going to call Baby Bro back up here for a little bit, and he's gonna tell you about, hi Miss Angie, he's gonna tell you guys about the next song we're gonna do. So, Jay, here he comes. Here he comes, slowly but surely, y'all. Slowly but surely. Oh, God. He said he's getting old. Are you serious?
I was joking. I'm just 20.
He's just 20, y'all. So, JJ, why don't you tell us about the next song we're going to play? Why don't you tell us about the next song we're going to play? Tell us about that.
Definitely. How's everybody doing? This next song, if you remember, if you were at the last concert, mm-hmm. we played one of my... So, I've only written two songs so far that are out. And so, the last concert, we played my first song. And the second, for this one, we're going to play my other one that I've written. And it's a part of a series that me and my best friend, Casey Baum.
Yeah, shout out Casey.
Phenomenal songwriter.
Yes, he is.
He helped me write these songs. If Miss Holly was watching, she knows who she is.
She knows.
But it's a series of songs that we're writing to a person whose nickname is Hollywood. And so this is the second song in that series. And there's probably going to be three, but right now there's two. So this is the second one. So I hope you guys enjoy it. It's called Ole Miss Hollywood.
There you go. You heard it here first, you guys. Jaran's original. That was Old Miss Hollywood, written by my baby bro, Jaran Huggins. Hey! Yes.
Definitely.
That's a gem. That's actually a bop, like, for real. Like,
you guys want to check out the actual song.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah, go on YouTube, type in his name, you'll find it. Really an amazing song that you did. So, I am always blown away by this level of talent back here.
Likewise.
Like, crazy.
Likewise.
And so, we will catch up with you later on the show.
Definitely.
So, he'll be back, guys. Once again, if you guys are just joining in, thank you so much for tuning into this. This is such a blessing to be able to inspire you and uplift you with some amazing music tonight. And we're just going to just keep it going here. I'm going to play now an original of mine. And I'm also taking it back to my second album, which is Visual. I had to think about it for a second. My second album, Visual, that I recorded down at the Potter's House in Jackson many, many moons ago. It was 2013. I was about to go off to college, and I was like a nervous wreck, like, geez, like, I could not. But wait, speaking of graduations, though, for real, I'm not sure if he's watching, but, I mean, I wrote it down. Matthew Dale, which is the son of a friend of my dad's, graduated from middle school today. So, happy graduation, congratulations, you're moving on to high school, it's amazing. You guys remember those days, right? Graduating from middle school, going into high school. It was a crazy, crazy time. But I'm inspired by you, and you're absolutely amazing. So keep working hard, kid. Hope to meet you one day. And so without further ado, we're going to go back to the Visual album and play a little number that I love, which is called Weekend in Cape Cod. Once I change the piano, though, because I can't play it on that.
Thank you.
That was a crazy time. As I was mentioning before the song, like I was just about to go off to college and I had to do this album, and my producer at the time was working at a Jacksonville, and went down to the Potter's House in Jacksonville, which is like a huge mega church association, and recorded that album. There were five songs with my first EP. I had my first professional photo shoot. And the best part was, is that at the time, my late grandfather, my grandfather and my great aunt, his sister, actually came to the studio to watch me lay down the tracks, which was super, super cool. That was a really good experience and an amazing time to share with them, actually watching me do the work that I do. So that always means something to me. So I think we're going to call the boy back for one more song. JJ, hey Jaran, we're gonna come back. He's moving really, really slow today. For some
reason, I don't know. Sorry,
Seth. There he is, of course. A mess. And so, this next song we're gonna do is probably one of my favorites. I don't know, have you guys heard of Lizzo? I'm sure you probably have. She's the new, do what?
No, no, that was the name of the song.
Oh, yeah. She's a newer artist, or I guess she is. I don't know, I kind of just discovered her, but she's an amazing, amazing performer and artist, and she also plays the flute, which is crazy. It's outstanding. She's great, and she's powerful, and I don't think anybody has ever done a dueling piano cover of one of her songs.
That was a song, yeah.
And so we're going to be the first to do it. So this is Lizzo's Juice. The way we know how to do it.
Thank you.
I mean, what is there left to say? I mean, are you serious? Are you serious? Y'all, are you serious? I'm sorry, y'all. I mean, after that, I'm just like, what was going on? Some of that stuff I ain't never heard before.
Same with him. Same with him.
Jeez.
That's my reaction.
I mean, y'all, one of you guys out there has to know Lizzo. Like, that, somebody has got to, like, send that over to her. So if anybody out there knows, anybody who knows anybody, send it to Lizzo. Because, I mean, really, she's so humble. Like, she would love that. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I hope you guys enjoyed baby bro Jaran, who came to accompany me tonight. And it was featured here on the virtual show. So we'll catch up with him after this last song. Yep. So, yeah, that was Lizzo's Juice. If you guys haven't heard that song, it's really a good song. I that's my workout playlist. Woo. Well, anyway, we've come to near the end, essentially. Lizzo, somebody said Lizzo. Oh God. I appreciate that. We've come near the end. Again, thank you so much for joining. It's not over yet. I have one more song. But I just wanted to thank you guys so much. For tuning in, and I hope you're being blessed by this night of music. There's so much craziness in the world, so many things are going on, and so I'm just happy to be able to spend an hour out of my day to give you guys a little bit of joy through some music, because music is healing, and all my songwriters and artists who are watching me know what that's about. It's our responsibility as artists to help the world and to, you know, bring joy to people, and that's why we do what we do. It's never solely about us. It's always about what we can do for other people. And, you know, that's one of the privileges of being an artist. So, literally last night we kind of did that, but we didn't go as much. We're like, oh, this is going to be like crazy. Like, we can keep it going forever. And then we'll both be tired. We won't want to do any more. But I do want to leave you with one song. We'll see if I can get through it, because, goodness, like, I feel like I've, like, lifted, like, 20-pound weights. But I'm gonna kind of, you know, end it on a slower note, but a more inspirational note, with a little Queen Bee for you. Little Beyonce, this is my take on the famous hit Halo. Hope you enjoy it. Pray for me. Thank you. Well, that was Halo by Queen Bee, Beyonce. What a way to end. I can see all of you guys as Halos. I appreciate you guys tuning in. Thank you so much for the support. It truly, truly means a lot. I hope you are blessed by it. Hi to everybody that joined in. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You know, we got to make sure that we spread joy everywhere. I can only do so much. We can only do so much. And so, you know, if you could share this video, share it to people who, you know, you think need an uplift, some type of encouragement. You know, music really does help. And so we're excited to be a part of your evening. And we'll do another one of these soon. So thank you guys so much. Please stay safe. Please stay healthy. Stay in. Anything you want
to
add?
You said everything. I was trying to make it up here before you.
Wasn't he amazing tonight, though, for real? No. Like, wasn't he? I mean, like, the keyboard's, like, burning, like, I have to, like, fan it.
That's, no.
Like, I mean, it's absolutely, I mean,
He's too nice. He's too nice.
This is my best friend right here. But I truly appreciate all of you guys, and looking forward to the next concert.
That's right.
But in the meantime, stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll talk to you guys soon. God bless you. Bye. God bless you. Bye. See ya.